Okay, so it always bugs me when people start at the outside of the room they're showing, but here I am doing that. So here we go. Here is the outside of my office door. We're gonna come in and open it up. And you might hear like construction equipment in the background. That's because my neighbors are putting in their yard this weekend and today. So that's where we're at. So this is what it looks like walking into my office, and I have to preface this with a couple different things. First, that this is by no means a pristine craft room. This is a working craft room. I'm in here every single day. Sometimes I don't clean up. In fact, a lot of the times I don't clean up until I need the space. So I know there are a lot of crafters out there that are like that as well, that you just don't even want to worry about cleaning up until the next time you're working. So the state it's in right now, while cluttered, is very, very clean for me. So, welcome to my craft room. I cleaned up just for you guys. So, I have moments of good organization, but by no means is it completely organized. The second thing I wanted to make note of is that I'm not your typical at-home crafter that crafts a couple times a week. This is my job every single day. So the plethora of supplies you're going to see is not a representation of the average crafter. I work for an online store. I work for Simon Says Stamps. So a lot of the things that you're going to see in my craft room area, I mean, I normally probably wouldn't have all this on my own, right? I mean, you guys understand where that's coming from. So, I mean, you just have to know that. And it's gonna show because I'm gonna have a lot of stuff. So I'm not gonna go into drawers and show everything, but I will show you those moments of organization that I think are really nice. So I'm gonna come in here and walk in, and I'm gonna turn around and close the door. Okay, so that's the door that I just walked in from. And to the left, right there, I have, well, when I'm walking in, it's on my right. I have these two really large calendars. They're actually just paper calendars that are laminated. I bought them on Amazon. And they're really nice. You can use dry erase markers on them. I'm not going to go in super close on them because I've got a lot of stuff that's planned that's coming up and all that. But I did want to show you those calendars because they're really, really nice. And let's see, to the left of that, I have a big, huge wooden K that I received from a friend for Christmas a couple years ago. I'm not sure where she bought it, but I'm pretty sure it is Helvetica, the font. And she may have bought it on Etsy. I'm not entirely sure. If any of you are really interested in getting a large letter like that, message me on YouTube or send me an email at my blog, and I'll contact my friend and see if she can tell me where exactly she bought it. But it was a gift, so I didn't ask where it was from. I just loved it. And it's hanging on the wall with, I'm no handyman, but I just put a couple nails in the wall. You know, I put a nail right down there and I put a nail right there because that's where I, you know, determined that most of the weight would be. So that's where I put the supports for the case. So right next to that, I have two Alex drawer units from IKEA and I have labels on them. So you can kind of see, like in this top drawer, I have embossing and interactive card stuff like action wobblers, and I have all my WoW embossing. Oh, this is a fun drawer because it's so colorful. Ta-da! And they actually sent me some of these molds to do some kind of like my own shapes. So I'm going to try to do that soon. I've been meaning to. Hopefully, I'll be able to try that in a little bit and I'll show you guys exactly what that's all about. So here's the embossing and interactive stuff. These drawers are really, really deep. If you can see how deep that is. So you can really fill them up. I'm still determining exactly what I want to put in all of these drawers. Coming down to adhesives, I have all my usual adhesives like my foam, clear foam, tape runner, things like that. And then right below that is refills and specialty stuff like my Xyron and, you know, refills for my Tombow stamp runner. Watercolor masking paper, distress paints. This has all of my distress paints, and my perfect pearls are in there too because I'm not sure where I'm putting them, but all my distress paints, and then Tim Holtz stencils. And these little circular labels can be found on the rangerink.com website. You can print them out on label paper and put them right on your bottles,
Or you can print them out on regular paper, maybe run them through your Xyron, something like that. But you can use a 3/4 inch circle punch, and it's the perfect size. So those drawers down there, I'm still trying to figure out what I'm doing with, so I'm not going to open those up. This top drawer over here has the dry erase marker stuff for the calendar that's right up there. And then I also have some of my calligraphy inks in here, some that are too tall for the space where I have the rest of them. So I'll show you guys that in a minute, but this is where I keep all the ones that are too tall. A whole bunch of glitter, have all my distress glitter in there. And then rhinestones and enamel dots. And then the rest of these drawers, I'm still figuring out. They're a mixture of a bunch of stuff. I need to go through and organize them. So coming to the top of that, those drawer units, I have 2 Stampin' Up! Color Caddies. The first one has all Stampin' Up! Inks on them, except for one row of, there's some Adirondack inks and some Hero chalk inks. But there's three whole columns, I guess you would call it, three whole columns of Stampin' Up! Inks. And this is a Color Caddy with the extender on it. It's taller than this one right here, which has all Hero Arts inks. So I've got all my shadow inks and dye inks, things like that. So there's that. Then I have 2 8x8.5x11 paper storage units. These are from stampandstorage.com. And I don't have them labeled because I've always just had them in this order, and so I kind of know what I'm looking for. So up at the top, I have the very first slot. Right here is Nina Solar White, then Nina Desert Storm. And then I've got a bunch of Hero Arts layering papers, which I might take out and replace with some other things because I don't use them quite as much anymore. But anyway, then at the beginning of the second one, I have some Be Creative tape and also some white wood grain paper from Simon Says Stamp. Then I've got, this is 120-pound ultra-thick cardstock from Simon Says Stamp. And then, let's see, what's this one? Oh, this is the Copic Expressive paper and some cardstock vellum. And then my favorite, Basil Marshmallow, big huge stack of it. And then various cardstocks. Most of them are Basil. So directly to the left of that, I have my Copic storage units. You guys have seen this in a previous video, or maybe it was just a post on my blog. And I keep my kind of plastic leftover containers filled with embossing powder. And I like to store a spoon in there with it. I don't know if you guys can see that spoon in there with it. And I have a bunch of ink pads down below that I need to put back in their homes. And let's see, up here above I also have extra label tape for my label maker, which is right down here. There's my label maker. And I use that when I'm labeling new stamp sets that are going in storage buckets. So there's my label maker. And I also have all my ink swatches right here. I don't reference these quite as much. I really want to redo them so that the whole surface of the tag has a stamped color on it. I think it'd be a little bit easier to use. Okay, so I'm gonna back out so you can see the whole desk. You can see my heat tool that's on the corner there and my circle cutter. I use that big bottle of Static Guard to prop up the paper behind my cards when I take photographs of them. So I don't really even use that Static Guard. I think it's an empty bottle, but it's just heavy enough to prop up that paper. So also on the corner of the desk, you'll notice I have some random like post-it paper, sticky tape, and that's for when I'm die cutting. I just grab a little corner of that and use that as my washi tape or to hold down the dies. So let's see, keep my work surface right there, and underneath the work surface I have put some shelf liner, no slip shelf liner. That's because my camera's right above and I don't want to have to reposition it every time I'm making a card on video. Okay, so these two, there's actually 4 units here. Let me move this light out of the way. There's actually 4 units here. You guys have seen the really large one on the left, on the bottom. That is the Distress ink pad holder from Stampin' Storage. the one directly to the right of that is, it's actually a custom ink pad storage that I contacted them and asked them if they would make one for me, because I wanted it to fill this space in between the Copic and my wall over there. I'm at a corner desk, and so there's a lot of dead space kind of back in the corner, and I wanted to kind of, for one thing, block that so I wouldn't be dropping things back there, and then I also just wanted it to have like a full kind of wall going across that area. So this has three columns for all these ink pads, and then there's 12 slots going up, so it holds 36 ink pads. I have all of my Memento Luxe pads in there right now, and I think I'm gonna put all of those extra ones, I'm gonna move those over there too. So up above that unit right there, this is where I keep a lot of my calligraphy stuff. So I've got my erasers, I've got an ink, a couple different inks, and some drawing gum, and some, what do they call those? They're kind of like ink wells, but like when you need to put the ink in the well. Anyway, up there I have nibs and paper, or nibs and, nib holders, like the pen holder. Above the Distress ink pads, I've got two cases of ink daubers. Got a big punch there and one leftover marker that's the Picket Fence white marker that doesn't fit in the ink pad holder down below. I keep my clear blocks right up there too. And then over here, gotta move my chair. Okay, I just had to turn these around. Over here, right here, is a stack of Avery L storage pockets that already have the paper in them. And that's for when I open up a new stamp set and I need to put it in a pocket right away. So then I come over and I grab my label maker and I make a label. And then I put it directly on the storage pocket so I'm ready and, you know, ready to go. Above that, I just have a couple things. I have my Stampin' Up! Markers. I also have the, well, what is this called? Some sort of palette. It's from Tim Holtz. And you can put all your Distress re-inkers in there and then watercolor with them. This goes to my mic. This is the mic that I usually wear when I'm on camera and I'm like talking as I craft. Have some twine. And then this is a light desk, a light table that I've had for a really long time. I don't use it very often. It's not even plugged in at the moment. These shelves are actually from Pottery Barn, and don't look too closely because they don't line up. It was me and my dad and my brother installing them, and it was a mess. And we never installed shelves like this before. So if I ever move and I need to take these shelves down, I definitely know how to do it now. That's the good part. So I just keep some random things up here. This is mostly stuff that I just want to keep off my work surface. I know how I work, and the way I work is that it needs to be within arm's reach for me to use it often. And these shelves are a little bit too high to be arm's reach. So I don't like store a lot of stuff up there that I use all the time. So I have two, let me zoom in for you. I have two clear shoe boxes that are filled with cards. You can kind of see that they're all filled with cards. And right next to me, I have some just random storage stuff. This is where my organization takes a drop. There's not a whole lot going on right here. Okay, over here, just to the side of my desk, let me move my chair back in. To the side of my desk, I have my paper trimmer, my Big Shot machine, baby wipes, and I tried these little ink away cleaning wipes for your stamps. Ugh, I wasn't a big fan, but I'm gonna use them until they're gone. And then I have one of these fridge bins containers that Jennifer McGuire talks about, and she uses it quite a bit. I have all of my, well, not all, I'm still going through old stuff, but I have the bulk of my stamps and dies all in these little pockets, and then I've labeled them so I can see what they are, and I need to go through and organize them. But anyway, these back here are ones that don't fit, or they're like stickers or something. And then I have my smaller stamps right there too. But this bin is generally for stamps and dies and products that I'm needing to use soon. It's stuff that's new to me, or I've only had for a short time. And so I really want to make sure that I use them. So backing up, here is my other corner desk. And by the way, this corner desk over here is the Gallant corner desk from IKEA. And then I got a matching one for this corner of my room. I'm not going to go into big, huge detail on this corner of my room, but basically I've got my iMac and my second 27-inch display. Up on top of that shelf right here, I have my Silhouette Cameo, and I also have my camera equipment over to the side. I've got my color Epson printer, and I have two little file drawer units from IKEA. And, oh, I forgot to show you guys this. I actually have a drawer unit underneath that desk right there. That's an Alex drawer unit as well. So, okay. So, over here, and then I've got my, well, I've got my fan in the middle of the room. I've got to move the fan. I'm so prepared for you guys. Okay, so on the top of this Expedit bookcase, I have a bunch of nail polish stuff. And this is all stuff that, it's a lot of my, well, it's kind of like the new polishes that I've been meaning to use and things like that. Just got a bunch of polishes. This is actually a box of stuff I need to send away to a friend. Got all my nail polish, my nail stamping plates, and my polish remover. And I use a Ranger craft sheet to protect my desk when I'm painting my nails, and that works really well. And then these two shelves here, I have four of those fridge bins that you saw over at my other desk. And these have more of those stamps and dies in storage pockets. This one obviously needs some help. There's nothing in storage pockets yet. But these up here, I've been gradually transferring everything over into storage pockets. Over here is a little tiny little shelf bookcase that I've had since college. I've had it for ages. And I'm just storing some sewing stuff on there right now, just random fabric on top, and I've got some dies down below. This closet right here, it's too small to really film inside it, so I'll just tell you what's in there. I have a bookcase rack in there that has 12x12 paper storage on it. I don't use a whole lot of 12x12 paper anymore, mostly just for backdrops on when I'm taking a picture of a card, but that's what that is. And then I have this big canvas of the United States. This is a design that I did when I worked at Basic Gray. And you can actually buy it at their website if you want something like that. And it's 30 by 50 inches, I think. Down here, I have another one of those Alex drawer units. And I have a new Little Brother laser printer on top. I've been doing a lot of black and white printing, and it seems a wise investment to get a laser printer. That, and I can use that for when I want to print out digital images for Copic coloring as well, because those were kind of made, like Copics were made to work with toner. So using a toner-based printer works well for that. I have a bunch of cardstock right here. And I tried to put them in hanging file folders of similar colors. Like this is a yellow hanging file folder and there's yellow cardstock inside. So it's really super bright and colorful. I really love that. And then down below I have some full sheets of felt as well. And I'm trying to think if there's anything else I wanted to cover. This is basically my craft room. Oh, my camera and how it's set up. I have a lot of people ask about this. Let me see if I can get a good angle on this. Okay, so you can see that there's like up there on the shelf, there's two clamps. One clamp is on the bottom end of the shelf, and then the other clamp is attached to the top clamp, and it also has this is like a monopod attached through that clamp. So it's a double super clamp with a monopod. And then, sorry, trying to get this angle. There's a ball head mount, and then the camera, which is on the very end. And this is kind of a souped up setup here. So go over to my blog. There will be links to this exact setup if you want to do something like this. But I like it because it gets my camera off my desk. I don't have to take it down. I can sit down and just start filming right away. And I also like it because this desk, while very sturdy, sometimes shakes. And so if I have a tripod on my desk with the camera on it, not only does the desk shake, but then the tripod shakes, then the camera shakes, and then there's a whole lot of shaking going on when I'm filming. So probably for the last month and a half or so, I've had my camera mounted on a shelf again, like it did at my old house, and it's helped the shaking quite a lot. I don't know if you guys noticed any difference in that, but it really helped. So this is basically my craft room. I have some areas that I love more than others. I really love the large K, and it's right by the United States wall or the United States canvas right there. I really love that area. So this is basically my craft room. It's not super fancy. It's a lot of like a mod podge of like a whole bunch of stuff all together. It's definitely not one of those streamlined craft rooms where everything matches, but it works for me, you know? So if you take anything from this, make your craft area. I mean, if you're working out of a bag, make that your own. If you have a whole room to yourself like I do, make it so that it works for you. You don't want to just copy someone else's stamp room or craft room because it looks nice. Although that is really cool and it, you know, makes you feel nice when you're inside it. But if it's not functional for you, then there's no reason to do it. And those type of rooms can be really expensive. So for me, little elements like this that keep everything within reach works really well. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video and I will catch you guys next time.
Wow, that was a long video. Thanks for sticking in there with me, guys. That first video you see on the left is actually when I gave Organized Like Jen a little tour of my hall closet, showing kind of my travel closet area. The one in the middle, the video in the middle, is when I organized my Distress ink pad holders. You guys might remember that video, so check that out. And the very last video is actually my old craft room tour from years ago, from like 4 years ago. So a lot has changed since then. So I will catch you guys later today for another Friday Focus video. Until then, thanks for watching.